مشاهدينا الكرام، أهلا ومرحبا بكم. العلاقات الكويتية الأمريكية مميزة وعميقة وتزداد متانة في ظل تطابق الرؤى في القضايا الدولية خاصة في الشرق الأوسط. وتأتي زيارة حضرة صاحب السمو أمير البلاد الشيخ صباح الأحمد الجابر الصباح حفظه الله ورعاه في 6 سبتمبر إلى الولايات المتحدة لتعزز أواصر التعاون بين البلدين. ولتسليط الأضواء على هذه الزيارة، يسعدنا أن نستضيف اليوم السفير الأمريكي لدى الكويت سعادة السفير لورنس سيلفرمان. أهلا ومرحبا
بكم. أهلا بكم وأهلا لكل المشاهدين الكرام.
سعادة السفير، هذه أول مرة لك في الكويت، وقد مضت سنة حتى الآن في منذ تسلمتم هذا المنصب. كيف ترون دولة الكويت؟ ما هو انطباعكم عن المجتمع الكويتي؟
شكرا يا أحمد. Well, I visited Kuwait 3 times actually, briefly. Before I came here in 2013, 14, and 15 for the conferences that Kuwait hosted, the donors' conferences for the refugees, which is one of the most important international initiatives that Kuwait has taken. But since my wife and I arrived here 1 year ago, we've been greeted with great hospitality. We're very happy here in Kuwait. We're very honored to be working on such an important relationship that we have between the United States and Kuwait. And it's also great to see so many Kuwaitis who have had exposure to the United States. Those who have been educated in the United States, like yourself and others, it's really not just the government-to-government connections, which are very close, but it's really the people-to-people connections that are so close.
سعادة السفير، كيف تصفون العلاقات الكويتية الأمريكية؟
Well, I think you said it, Ahmed, when you spoke about the distinguished and deep relationship that we have. That's exactly right. But even as close as they are, and they really are strategic, and I'm not just talking about because of liberation, but of everything that's gone on since liberation. This is important to us, as important to us, meaning the U.S. government, and to the American people, as it is to the Kuwaiti government and the Kuwaiti people. And what we, as close as the relationship is, we've always thought we can do more, and that's what we're in the process of doing. We can enhance the relationships across the board. One thing I want to stress at the outset is that the United States remains committed to the security of Kuwait. And so we have this very deep and defense and security relationship, but the relationship is much, much broader than that. It's about very close relations in trade and investment, but also cultural and, for example, in education.
سعادة السفير، كيف ترون الزيارة التي سيقوم بها حضرة صاحب السمو أمير البلاد إلى الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية؟
Well, we're very, very much looking forward to His Highness's visit and to his meeting with the President on September 7th at the White House. As a matter of fact, the President has just sent His Highness a message saying that he's looking forward, very much looking forward to the visit. The Emir, of course, His Highness has visited and met with all American presidents before, and it's the Emir is held with great respect in the United States by Americans and certainly by our government. So we look at His Highness's visit as a marking of how important this relationship is, and also to plan for the future, what we can do together between us. And I can tell you that, for example, when the President and His Highness spoke even back in February, they were not just talking about security, fighting terrorism, defeating Daesh. They were also talking about the importance of, for example, education and the students that go to the United States and then come back here and help develop Kuwait. So it's an honor for us to be receiving His Highness in just over a week. And we look forward to a very broad discussion on the bilateral relationship, which is the real reason for the visit, but also, as you know, many regional issues, including the Gulf, the issue within the Gulf Cooperation Council right now.
سعادة السفير، ماذا عن الحوار الاستراتيجي الذي يعقد في سبتمبر بين الكويت وأمريكا؟
Well, Ahmed, we started this strategic dialogue. We launched it last October, and I had the privilege of going back not long after I arrived here in Kuwait to go back for that strategic dialogue. And I want to stress to your viewers that this is not about some high-level discussion, just a high-level discussion between governments and leaders. This has very practical benefits for people, the Kuwaiti people, and I think for the American people as well. Yes, it provides more security to them. We are building up the capabilities of Kuwait's armed forces. We are working very, very closely in security cooperation to defeat or prevent any further terrorist attacks here in Kuwait. But we are also looking at ways that we can enhance trade. We can enhance investment in both countries, and I know Kuwait is keen to get more investment here from around the world to Kuwait, and is changing some of its policies in order to do that. We are trying to expand cultural cooperation, and we are, for example, will be deciding on very specific ways to deepen the relationship on education. So I really do want to stress that it has an impact for people's lives here in Kuwait, and in the end, the strategic dialogue is designed not as a meeting, one-day meeting, but for things that we give ourselves, the work that we give ourselves to do all the rest of the year to enhance that relationship that provides, in the end, more security for Kuwaitis and Americans, but also greater prosperity for Kuwaitis and for Americans.
كيف تقيمون دور الكويت في حفظ الأمن والسلام في العالم وخاصة في منطقة الشرق الأوسط؟
Kuwait plays an enormously important role in the region. You mentioned, with respect to His Highness, the humanitarian role that Kuwait plays. And I want to stress to your viewers that the role that Kuwait plays is not a regional role. It's a global role. Kuwait is a global leader in humanitarian activities, not just for the region. You know, there are things that Kuwait does all over the globe to help in Asia, in Africa, elsewhere, not just the region. But within the region, what it has done, not just to help, for example, with refugees, but to help those countries that are hosting the refugees. So I think Kuwaitis, I hope Kuwaitis are very proud of that role, because they should be. We are very appreciative, deeply appreciative of it, and I'm sure the President will say that to His Highness when he's there. And it is not just, it is not charity, it's not just khairiyya. I would say istithmar fil istiqrar, it's an investment in stability of the region, this assistance that that Kuwait provides. And as you know, Kuwait is a major diplomatic player here in the region. And if we look just now at the dispute within the Gulf Cooperation Council, you see that Kuwait is trying to mediate, and the United States fully supports the role of His Highness and Kuwait more generally in this effort to reach a settlement by getting the parties really to sit down as soon as possible, because we do value the internal unity of the GCC.
سعادة السفير, ثلاث سنوات مضت على تكريم حضرة صاحب السمو أمير البلاد قائدا للعمل الإنساني والكويت مركزا للعمل الإنساني. كيف تقيمون هذا التكريم؟
Well, I think, again, I go back to Kuwait and His Highness having a vision of stability in the region. What does that take? You know, what is the role of Kuwait or any other country in not just talking about the need for stability, but doing something about it? And that's what Kuwait is doing. When I say that, I mean the government, and there's the Kuwait Fund, and then there's the Arab Fund, and the great activities of the Kuwaiti Red Crescent, which is very important. Every single day, not, you know, you read about the activities every single day. And the diplomacy, which is really looking and saying, how do you stabilize a region? His Highness has a very long record in this, 40 years as, over 40 years as foreign minister, and now as emir. And I think we all appreciate that he has that vision. He understands the past, he understands the vision and the importance of having closeness in the region and having unity in the region, because this region is facing tremendous threats and challenges from all over, maybe unprecedented threats. And so I think this is all part of the same picture, and that by setting this example in many cases, especially on the humanitarian role, it is also not just doing these things, it is sending a signal to others to encourage them also to play a humanitarian role. And just to give you the latest example, we all know the history of this country. Kuwait has offered and will host, inshallah, the reconstruction conference for Iraq sometime early next year. And that gives you an idea, that again is an investment in the stability of the region.
سعادة السفير، كيف ترون الجهود الكويتية الأمريكية في مجال مكافحة الإرهاب؟
So I think that it's fair to say that over the last few years we have increased our cooperation. Unfortunately, Kuwait has been the victim of a terrorist attack, the largest one having been at the Imam al-Sadiq Mosque about a little over 2 years ago. And unfortunately that brought home to Kuwait who the enemies are. But not just since then, before then, but especially since then and in the past few years, we really have developed even a closer cooperation, which is mutually beneficial. It's helping secure, I believe, provide greater security to Kuwait, but it's also providing greater security in the region. And it's really at the top of our agenda. And I would say, in addition to fighting terrorism, there's the issue of stopping terrorist financing, the financing by which terrorists benefit. And we're united in that effort. That was a big theme of the summit in Riyadh in May, which is the time that the His Highness the Emir met with the President. And as you know, all of the GCC countries agreed with us to make even a further priority of stopping terrorist any financing to terrorist causes.
سعادة السفير، هناك طبعا تعتبر هذه الزيارة لحضرة صاحب السمو إلى الولايات المتحدة الأمريكية هي الأولى للرئيس دونالد ترامب منذ تولي هذا المنصب. ماذا تعتقد أبرز المواضيع التي سيتم نقاشها خلال هذه الزيارة؟
Well, first of all, I'm sure that they will discuss the recognition of the importance of this relationship and what we each get out of the relationship. I think that the Kuwaiti government and the Kuwaiti people appreciate what the United States has done here in Kuwait. I'm not talking just about liberation, but all of the cooperation that we've had since then. And I know there is a deep appreciation in Washington and in the Trump administration a great appreciation for the role, the stabilizing role of Kuwait. We very much appreciate the access that we have been given militarily in order to help in the fight to defeat Daesh, and we're making great progress in that area. I'm pleased to say, and again, that's not just good for Americans, that's good for Kuwaitis and all of us throughout the region. So they will be talking about that. They will, I think, have a bit of an agenda of how do we deepen that relationship. As I said to you before, it's very close, but there's always more that we can do. We will continue to build up the defense capabilities of help with the building up of the defense capabilities of Kuwait so it can defend itself. We will continue to build upon our cooperation in the security field. We will look for ways to enhance investment and trade between the two. And we have over 15,000 Kuwaiti students studying in universities right now. We want more. And so we will be looking at ways, how can we cooperate more with respect to higher education? How can we've trained, in specialty fields, in addition to all the education, we've trained 1,700 people in various programs, civilian-wise, and in addition to the military training. We can actually enhance training in the security areas, for example, in how you prosecute terrorists and criminals, but also in the technology field, bringing more technology here, sharing scientific research, things like that. So that's, I think they will get into that. I'm sure, depending on where the situation is at the time of the visit next week, I'm sure they will be discussing the GCC dispute. For obvious reasons, Iraq, Iran, they'll be discussing Syria, and again, we will appreciate, and I know the President will appreciate the views of His Highness, given his long experience and his long involvement in the diplomacy of the region.
سعادة السفير، دولة الكويت حليف رئيسي من خارج حلف الشمال الأطلسي الناتو.
Yes.
ماذا تعتقد برأيكم أضاف هذا للمنظومة الأمنية؟
Right. It's very interesting because Kuwait is now the site of the only NATO facility, NATO-related facility in the Middle East, which is the new, what we call the Istanbul Cooperation Initiative facility. coming out of a previous summit, NATO summit. And that will be used, I think, as an opportunity to deepen the relationship between NATO and this region. And really, in that sense, Kuwait is a pioneer here, because it created this center, and we want to make the maximum use of that. There can be various training that goes on there at the facility here. I'm sure that there'll be more and more interaction now that you have the facility between NATO and here. There's the NATO Parliamentary Assembly too that involves members of Parliament and your members of Parliament. One area that maybe we can work on as well bilaterally and in the NATO field is cybersecurity, for example, which is very important.
سعادة السفير, هل هناك كلمة أخيرة تود أن توجهها إلى الشعب الكويتي خاصة في هذه المناسبات وعيد الأضحى المقبل بعد يومين؟
First, I want to wish all of your Kuwaiti viewers from me and from my wife a blessed Eid al-Adha Mubarak. Kul am wa bkhair. I'd like to wish all of your guests and all the best wishes for the coming period from my family to yours.
شكرا سعادة السفير. إلى هنا مشاهدينا الكرام ينتهي هذا اللقاء مع السفير الأمريكي لدى الكويت, والذي نشكره على هذا اللقاء. دمتم بخير.